To understand semantic networks as a knowledge representation, let us take an example. This is an example that we saw in a previous lesson. This is A is to B, as C is to D, and we have to pick one of the six choices at the bottom that will go in D. How will we represent our knowledge of A, B, C, and the six choices at the bottom? Let us begin with A and B. We'll try to build semantic networks that can represent our knowledge of A and B. Inside A is a circle. I'll label it X. Also inside X is a diamond. I'll label it Y. Here is a black dot. I'll label it Z. We can similarly label the objects in B. So inside A are three objects, X, Y, and Z. So the first thing we need to do in order to build a semantic network for representing our knowledge of A is to represent the objects. So I have the object X, the object Y, the object Z, standing for the circle, the diamond, and the black dot. Now that we have represented the objects in A, we want to represent the relationships between these objects. So I have the objects X, Y, Z, and we'll try to represent the relationship between them by having links between the nodes representing the objects. These links can be labeled. So I may say that Y is inside X because that is the relationship in the image A. Similarly, I may say that Z is above Y because Z is above Y in the image A. I may also say that Z is above X because Z is above X in image A. In this way, a semantic network representation of the image A captures both the objects and the relationships between the objects. We can do exactly the same thing for the image B, the objects and the relationships between them. Y is above X. Now that we have represented our knowledge of image A and our knowledge of image B, we want to capture somehow the knowledge of the transformation from A to B. Because recall, A is to B as C is to D. So we want to capture the relationship between A and B, the transformation from A to B. To do that, to capture the transformation from A to B, we'll start building links between the objects in A and the objects in B. Now, for X and Y, that is straightforward. For Z, well, there is no Z in B. So we'll have a dummy node here in B, and we will see how we can label the link here so that we can capture the idea that Z doesn't occur in B. So we might say that X is unchanged because X, the circle here, is the same as the circle here. Y, on the other hand, has expanded. It was a small diamond here, and it's a much bigger diamond there. Z, the black dot, has disappeared altogether, so we will say it's deleted. It's not there in B at all. I hope you can see from this example how we constructed a semantic network for the relationship between the images A and B. There were three parts to it. The first part dealt with the objects in A and the objects in B. The second part dealt with the relationships between the objects in A and the relationship between the objects in B. The third part dealt with the relationship between the objects in A and the relationship between the objects in B. In principle, we can construct semantic networks for much more complicated images, not just A and B. Here is another example of a semantic network for another set of images. Once again, we have the objects and the relationships, and then the relationship between the objects in the first image and that in the second image.